Because you know I'm all about the Xbox, about the Xbox. No fanboy, I'm all about the Xbox, about the Xbox. No fanboy.
It's a vlog.
I got a haircut, yeah. Hi, I'm Steven, welcome to Stacey Films, it's a vlog. So, what videos I made this past 1 week? I made some film sketch videos, hooray, finally, because I've been lacking on doing some film sketch videos, let alone doing, like, certain ones I never got round to doing. Yeah, I haven't finished a script on that. I've been really lacking on film sketch videos lately, but it's nice, however, to make some kind of film sketch videos type videos, one of which, and it was my 8-year anniversary on YouTube, and I did a film sketch video, and there was like a bit of reference from my very first video that I made, and plus certain night of that just I couldn't do a very good speech, but I just cut up something in the end. And yeah, I like to thank you guys for congratulating me on all that, which I like to thank you guys very much on that. And also the other thing that I did video wise was a different sort of video. Sure, it was kind of a film sketch video type thing, but it was something that I wanted to make and wanted to share with you guys, and there's the 5 things you didn't know about the Xbox One. And I thought I'd do this sort of video, because I do mention these sort of theories and things on my vlog sometimes, but it's nice, however, to put into one sort of video and share it with you guys. And a really good positive feedback on that, which is really, really good, because most of you didn't even know most things. And however, even though I'm still learning and finding out new theories about the Xbox One, but still, how nice, however, just to show you guys what I know so far, and I'm still learning as I go along. But overall, I would, however, make a sequel on that, but still, however, yet again, I'm still learning when it comes to doing various things on them, theories, and plus learning new ways to do stuff on the Xbox One and whatnot. So yeah, those are the videos I made this past 1 week. Just want to quickly mention before I start off these topics, and that is, I know I've been mentioning loads about Xbox-related things, a few vlogs now, and I'd like to say sorry about that. But you know what I'm kind of like, I'm all about that Xbox, about that Xbox. Anyways, so yeah, this past 1 week, people that are in the preview program have been getting access to the November update, and I've got that this past 1 week. Even though I would make videos about these previews, but then again, I did mention this a few times in my vlogs now, even though if I'm allowed to or not allowed to, you see. But I do mention them in my vlogs, and I think it's okay to do that anyways. But overall, the November update is really, really good. I'm really enjoying it. It's nice to add, like, the bio that you had on the Xbox 360, plus, like, you've got this, like, nice showcase. We can showcase your uploads, and plus the achievements that you did, which is quite a nice feature, showing the showcase on your profile, showing all the stuff you can do, which is quite nice. But the major thing that loads of people have been asking for these days, and there's the custom themes, which is really, really good. It's really nice, however, that you can actually also customize your themes when using the achievements you unlocked, which is quite nice. But however, as much as I like the custom themes, at the moment I've got a custom theme on my Xbox at the moment, but it's just, I really wanted the screenshot feature, as you guys may have known a few vlogs now, and basically I really wanted to try out the screenshot feature. But after a recent interview this past 1 week, along with the November update, the screenshot feature has kind of delayed until 2015. I'm like, no! The reason why, because of that, is because the holiday rush and stuff, and Phil Spencer doesn't want too much to handle when it comes to new Xbox One users in the holiday season, which is understandable, which I don't blame him. But other than that, though, it's nice that they kind of delayed it just to beat the holiday rush and all that, which is understandable, but I really wanted the screenshot feature, because I would like to take some screenshots and post them on Facebook and share and whatnot. A few vlogs ago, I mentioned that I don't usually use Reddit or have a Reddit account or whatnot. And funny which, because I found out these sort of things beforehand, before news sites do, basically, I kind of started using Reddit now. I haven't got like a Reddit account or anything like that. I just read up stuff on a subreddit on Xbox One, but it's just nice how for just to know things, and that's how I know about the screenshot feature being delayed before news sites got hold of this topic and stuff. But other than that, though, it's just nice to use Reddit now and again for various things when it comes to news-related things on the Xbox One. I would do other subreddits, but I've just been using subreddit on Xbox One at the moment. Yes, I'm a Reddit person now. God damn it, Reddit. Anyways, also when I was reading up on Reddit and stuff, basically the TV tuner has came out in this past 1 week. It's not out as of yet. There's been like some mixed dates, let alone my Xbox One camouflage control when it comes to accessory type things, because launching accessories is very, very complex than it is than game release type things. But other than that, the TV tuners kind of came out this past 1 week. I would, however, get the TV tuner because it is quite nice to be able to use the TV tuner when you want to watch TV and whatnot to play Xbox One at the same time. But the thing is, though, I hardly ever watch TV, even though that I do have like a Freeview type thing on my TV. But the thing is, though, because I had the TV on the opposite room, because when I had a rearrangement and stuff, and now it's on this side of the room, and basically the aerial is on that side, and never got around to getting a long-ish cable to connect to the aerial to the TV. But it's just that when I watched this how-to video about the TV tuner, you do need the aerial to be able to use the TV tuner, which I did some research before I found out this video. Also, that I did mention about this a few vlogs back, a few preview things that I mentioned about that I really wanted this feature, and there's the ability to use, like, say, a tablet, and basically, instead of watching TV on the tablet using the TV tuner, I thought you'd be able to, like, say, send signals on the HDMI cable, to send signals from the HDMI cable, and be able to play Xbox 360 games, even with the frame rate lag. I thought you'd be able to do that. But I've realised after watching the how-to video on the TV tuner, and basically it's just the TV tuner that does the signals and to broadcast TV stuff onto the tablet, not stuff onto the HDMI thing. So there's a new theory about that. It's just that when I first found out about the TV signals onto the Xbox Smart Glass, I thought, why can't you use the HDMI and basically run, the Xbox 360 and whatever, like the PS4 and stuff? But the theory is kind of unexactly, so basically you have to use the TV tuner to be able to use the onto the Xbox Smart Glass. Sorry if I'm over topicking, but I'm just mentioning about previous things I mentioned about stuff about theories and stuff. Oh, too much with Xbox. But other than that, though, I wouldn't mind getting a TV tuner, but I think it's a waste of time, because I'm quite happy with my on-demand service like 4OD, BBC iPlayer, and whatnot. Because I rarely watch TV shows, even though I'm really looking forward to The Big Bang Theory and plus Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. starting this week, even though it's already been out a few episodes in America. But still, I'm really looking forward to watching that and plus the rest of the episodes of Doctor Who. But other than that, though, yeah, I'm not much of a TV junkie, as most people would be. I'm mostly a YouTube junkie. On the last vlog, I mentioned quite briefly about Killer Instinct Season 2 and how much that it kind of changed. And plus, even though I lost most of my unlocks, I still kept most of my unlocks already unlocked. But basically, this past 1 week, due to the new system that they got, and the new XP system, plus instead of ranking and your own fight tiles, you rank up, you level up your character instead of fight tiles. Because originally, the original plan was I was going to unlock a certain colour skin, and basically because you have to unlock it by doing 150 fight titles. If you play Killer Instinct, you understand what I'm talking about. But instead of doing fight titles, instead though, you level up your character instead. And basically, it was easy to unlock and stuff by leveling up your character than it is the traditional fight titles instead. And even though it's been almost a year now, I really want to unlock this colour. And now I finally unlocked this colour because of the new system that they have. And I leveled up my own character to level 10. I finally unlocked the colour. It's just that it's just weird how easy it is to unlock stuff by level up your character than it is it was mostly time consuming on the previous update than it is in the season 2 update, which is quite funny actually. As I mentioned in the last vlog, also I lost most of my I still get to keep most of my unlocks, but some of the particular unlocks were harder to get and stuff on the previous updates, but on the newer update it's kind of more easier to get. But certain things, however, are quite hard to get now. I was just lucky enough to get a certain thing because you had to be like level 50 to get like a certain icon now, which is quite I was looking to get that because I did that with currency instead, but that's on the previous update. But other than that though, it's just nice to have to get certain unlocks that most people have to get, like a certain level, like level 50 to be able to get it. Unless you'll be able to use microtransactions. There has been like microtransactions on the season 2 updates. But other than that though, it's just that I managed to get most things without using microtransactions, even though I buy certain characters and whatnot. This past bomb week when I went into town, I went to my local cash converters, because sometimes, a few months back, and sometimes cash converters do some really cheap stuff when it comes to Xbox One related things, because they do have like a one game on display, and plus the console on display, because sometimes they tend to sell the console itself, because they do their consoles, the Xbox One consoles, really, really cheap. For example, this past one week, they did an Xbox One console for at least like £280, which is not bad buy. Considering the past one that I saw, they had like the Xbox One with the Kinect, plus the official headset, you know, the big headset that they have for Xbox One and stuff. And also that you get like Call of Duty and Assassin's Creed and all that. And it's almost like, I think it was like £310, £320. And that's just a real good bundle, that is. And like I said, this past one week I saw one for £280. But that's just the console with the Kinect, which is a not bad deal still. But the games, however, I saw this past one week was really, really surprising. Because like I said, they only do them one at a time. But for some reason, they've got like a bunch of Xbox One games on the shelf. And when I had a quick look at them, because like I said, they're doing quite cheap. And they were doing like £15 a pop a game, which is really, really cool. But some of them were like £18 to £20, but £15 a game, oh my god, that was brilliant. Even though that was quite, I'm not saying disappointed, it's just that some of the titles I already got, like Watch Dogs and Titanfall, Plants vs Zombies and some other titles, and they were like £15 each. I regret myself, even though that I got the games brand new and stuff, but still, it was still a good buy, however, because when I posted on Facebook, and my friend, as I mentioned a few vlogs ago, and my friend recently got an Xbox One, and I posted this on Facebook, and my friend's like, oh, I know what I'm going to get when I next get paid, and I said to him, yeah, go ahead, because most of the titles I've already got anyways. But there were certain titles that I haven't actually got, and I was going to plan to get Lego Marvel, that they did for £15. But as soon as I got my job pay, I recently got my job pay this past one week, and I had more than I expected, and I thought, oh, I might as well get that Lego game for £15. And then the day after, when I saw these games for £15 each, I went in and basically the Lego game was gone. So I couldn't get that though. However, they also had the Lego Hobbit for £15 as well, which I would have got that though, but I'm not big on Lord of the Rings or the Hobbit, and decided not to get though. I would get, however, and maybe do some gameplay of the DLC, because as you may know, not heard about this, but basically, because they haven't released the third Hobbit movie as of yet, and they did disclaimer and did say that once they released the third movie, they were going to do some free DLC for the Lego Hobbit game and basically release the first segment of the game on the Lego game, which is quite a nifty thing that they do for the Hobbit game. But still, I didn't want to get anyways. Even though it was like £15, which is a really good buy, considering they cost like about like £20 to £25 to £30, which you know seems quite expensive. It's just some Xbox One games can be a bit expensive and whatnot. But still, it was a really good price. However, in cash converters, maybe I'll wait until they get some other games like Forza 5 or any other games I might pick up in cash converters. But still, it's a nice thing to see that. But other than that, though, it's a nice thing that I might consider going there now and again and see if I can pick up some really cheap Xbox One games on in cash converters. Enough about Xbox for now. Let's talk about music. Yes, music, because this past one week, a certain thing happened, and basically I got some new headphones, which are these nice Skullcandy ones. Yes, they're just quite nice. And basically, as you may not know, I had these headphones for almost like a year now, and basically I got these headphones because these used to cost like £250, and they've been reduced to £30. I had these for a year now. They is kind of getting a bit worn out now, because there are some leather bits here that are getting a bit worn out on here. But other than that, I will use them quite a lot. And plus the wire on it is starting to get a bit really not working, because it would not work on my Windows phone, let alone on an iPod, to say. But it's just that the certain thing, however, it's just based on less speaker. Because what happened is on less speaker, because you take this out and you put batteries in to use the noise cancellations. And because there has been some rainy days, and basically it's because it can be easily get leaked. And basically I think because the less speaker did not work and did not work. And I think it's because of the leakage with the water damage. And plus the wire was a bit meh. Anyways, so I decided to get these Skullcandies instead, because I could do with some new headphones, and plus I needed something to be able to work onto my Windows phone, because I do use my Windows phone for music quite a bit when I had some other headphones, like say these, and plus the other Skullcandies that I had. But still, it's just nice having to get some other Skullcandies, because I had some Skullcandies before I got these ones. And I had Skullcandies, and I thought I'd decide to get some Skullcandies again, because it's just nice having to have Skullcandies. And these Skullcandies, it doesn't feel that big or that small. I actually said my thoughts on my Instagram post. But so, however, it's just nice, however, to get these sort of things, and they actually work on my Windows phone, so I can actually change in tracks while I'm walking, because sometimes I really would like using a remote when it comes to various things, because these cost about like £15 on its own without the remote, and basically it's £15 more with the remote, which just I find a bit silly. But Sava, I actually got these for about £20, and usually these cost about £30, and I actually got these for £20, which is not bad. So but Sava, it's nice to get these nice new headphones, and basically they actually work on my phone, so in case I do ever get a call or a text, which I rarely call or text people or whatever, but still, it's nice having to answer it than it is, since when I had the incident that I couldn't use my Windows phone, I've been using my iPod a lot for music. But yeah, speak about music in general, you know that particular song that's been top of the charts at the moment, you know, it's all about that bass, all that bass. I actually got that on Xbox Music, which I meant about Xbox Music stuff in a minute. But it's just that when I first heard about that music, this is the funny thing how I first heard about that music. And when I came home from Mum's on Sunday, and there was these lasses that were walking down my area near where I live, and they had like these rave rings that glow in the dark and stuff, and they were singing that. And then when I had my CEX friend over, and he was mumbling that song as well, and then I listened to it on Xbox Music. I was like, oh, might as well get it. And I purchased it on Xbox Music when I got some new recent tracks on Xbox Music, and which I actually got. Speaking about Xbox Music, as I mentioned on the last vlog, and there has been some issues on the Xbox One on Xbox Music, where basically I couldn't stream my paid music on Xbox One. It's finally been fixed this past 1 week, and I get to listen to my new tracks, and not only that, and listen to my all my other tracks as well, which is quite nice. As I mentioned, it had a bit of an issue, but it's now been fixed. And I think there was kind of a reason why they had some issues on the Xbox One, on Xbox Music, and not streaming my paid music. Because there was a certain thing that happened this past 1 week that they announced. Basically, they're cutting down the streaming service on Xbox Music on the 1st of December. If you may not have known, Xbox Music is quite popular for at the moment compared to Spotify, because basically they got this free streaming service where you can actually listen to 10 hours worth per month. And I do use it now and again when I want to listen to certain newer tracks and listen to them before I actually purchase them myself. But I'm really worried, however. Sure, I read up on the Q&A that this doesn't affect all paid music on Xbox Music, but I would like to buy these sort of musics on Xbox Music and plus learn that, listen to it on devices. But if I listen on certain devices, it might ask for an Xbox Music Pass, which I find a bit stupid, really, because I really want to listen to paid music, let alone asking for an Xbox Music Pass to be able to listen to your paid music. I just hope that this doesn't all go downfall, because I do love listening to my music on Xbox Music, as well as buying music with my phone credit and whatnot on my Windows phone. But just still, however, just we'll just see how it goes, really. But still, however, at the moment, I'm enjoying my new headphones and listening to some new tracks, like All That Bass and plus some other tracks that I recently got, like Bang Bang Into The Room and plus Anaconda and other types of mirrors musics. Just some ones that are on the top of the charts, and plus I got two tracks were featuring Forza Horizon 2. So anyways, what I've been up to, I got my job pay this past 1 week for this month, and I got more than expected, because usually I get whatever each month, but I actually got more than expected, which was quite good. And like I said beforehand, I well got the Lego Marvel game for £15 on Xbox One and cash conveyors, but it's gone, so oh well. But still, I might just put whatever money towards next month, even if there are certain games that we'll like to get in this month, as I mentioned before, even though that Sunset Overdrive comes out next week, which I'm saving up and getting at the moment. But even though that Fantasia Music Vault came out this past 1 week, and I mentioned my thoughts on the last vlog, and I would get, however, but I might get another time. But I'll be saving up most games for November anyways, and I'm looking forward to getting most games in November, even though I will be getting holiday pay maybe next month, but most of the holiday pay might be towards either, you know, getting the new Pokemon game, plus not getting Smash Bros. For Wii U. Oh, that Smash Bros. And Wii U Direct was brilliant, and I'm really looking forward to all the really cool features. I can't handle all these features, it's too much, you know, and stuff like that. Loads of people have been putting jokes on the internet. But other than that though, yeah, I'm looking forward to Smash Bros, and also getting the figure, because there are like certain figures that come out in November, but there'll be figures that are coming out in December. I would like to get the Luigi, you know, amiibo and stuff. But other than that though, it was just nice how this past 1 week I had no work or in training, which was quite nice, even though that on my work off, I was going to do that film sketch video, which was the 5 things you didn't know about the Xbox One, which I was going to plan to do on Wednesday, but instead I did on Tuesday instead, because I was expecting stuff to come out on PlayStation Network on Wednesday, but things didn't go as I wanted, because I wanted to get the if they was going to release the Fat Princess free-to-play game on PlayStation V and plus the revamped SingStar on Wednesday, but it didn't came out. So at least I've made some videos, that's what I'm pleased to do. But other than that though, it's just nice to have a bit of time off on various things and don't get stressed out too much. And I've been playing in Smash Bros. With my friend and crew Lord Soft, which was quite nice, because I had some unexpected messages on Facebook, and he was like, oh, come Skype me, talk to me, and play Smash Bros, which was quite nice, because I've been lacking on playing Smash Bros, and plus he said also he was lacking on Smash Bros, and we've been playing Smash Bros, and I won a few matches, which was quite nice. Which was nice and unexpected, because I rarely talk on Skype, and plus it was nice, however, that I get to chat to my online friends, who I mentioned a few times, and plus he visited my place a few times. Speaking about visitors, my CEX friend has been visiting a few times this past 1 week, which was quite nice. Not only that, plus my sister as well. But it was nice having to have some company, even though I have been lacking on socialising and stuff like that. But yeah, it's just, yeah, nice however. And also, if I mention way back, a few vlogs back the past following year, I mentioned about these floods that we had in my hometown in Grimsby. And while these plus were happening, I was looking up on my Facebook and Twitter feeds, and I found this geeky lass, and then I said hi and stuff like that, and she gave me all this gif back, and I was like, oh, fine, fair enough. And then this past 1 week, I actually saw her face to face, and she was in the bus, and I gave her a right old look, and I was just like, and she deserved it, however, because the way she was talking to me back and stuff, even though I was trying to be nice to her, trying to build conversation and stuff. But other than that, though, after that, however, basically she actually messaged me on Facebook, funny of which, and she was like, oh, I didn't mean to talk like that and stuff, and I showed her the app replies, and not saying the app replies, because she was tweeting about me, and basically I had replies saying, oh, I'm sorry, I was only trying to make friends and stuff, and she was like, oh, sorry, I've been rude and stuff, and we kind of made up, not make out, just made up and stuff like that, and yeah, she's just find it a bit, you know, too creepy that basically I just said hi and stuff like that, which is understandable, I guess. That's just me, however, because of my lack of social skills. And she tried to say stuff, and I didn't completely understand various things. Because she was like, you need to lay off a bit more when it comes to, you know, internet research and stuff like that, which is understandable. But other than that, however, this past 1 week, I've been chatting to someone online, and it was quite nice that I've been talking to this person. And she's into video games and whatnot, and she lives in Cleethorpes, which is basically the next thing onwards from Grimsby, which is not too far away. I do walk to Cleethorpes now and again. And she was into video games, and I said hi and stuff like that, and she can be a bit awkward and shy and stuff. She did say that, and plus she had a bit of disabilities and whatnot. I won't go into too much detail, like I usually do. But other than that, though, we had a bit of a nice, really conversation about video games and stuff. And she actually watched my YouTube videos, and she actually digs my YouTube videos, which is quite nice. Mainly my film sketch videos, because she was referring to my film sketch, my Steety film characters. And the funny thing is, though, we've just been like talking about video games and YouTube and stuff like that, and other than that. But it's just somehow, it kind of feels a bit iffy, a bit. I love the conversation about talking about YouTube and video games and whatnot. It still felt a bit iffy, because basically she doesn't have a Facebook due to some problems that she had. Plus like that, she only has like a Skype and not much social networking sites and stuff like that. And it just seems a bit iffy. Sure, I have been catfished many of the times, even though in a few years back, if you may recall, I had a relationship on Facebook, and I was catfished then. And I'm very, very upskill when it comes to being aware of certain females on the internet. But yeah, I mentioned that on the vlog years back. But other than that, though, just still have, I was trying to be aware, but it's just I'm trying to do something in life and stuff like that. I just didn't want to end up like the thing that happened a few years back. But so it's just nice how we do chat now and again, even though she doesn't reply as much, but like I said, it's just a bit iffy. But so it's just nice to talk about video games and try and socialise a bit and all that, but other than that though, I'm fine and dandy, just been making YouTube videos and just what happens with the course of the past 1 week that happens with me. That's vlogs for years. But other than that though, what videos I'll be doing next week? The Evolve Alpha will be happening next week, which I'll hopefully do some gameplay of, which hopefully when I get the... Because I signed up for it, I just hopefully get a code and do some gameplay for you guys, because you're allowed to do some gameplay and whatnot, which I'm really looking forward to doing some gameplay on that following day, even though it's a certain someone's anniversary at on October 30th, on the Thursday. But other than that, though, I'm looking forward to getting in Sunset Overdrive when it comes out on Halloween. I would like to mention this again, that I would love to do a Halloween special, even though I did one last year, but I wanted to skip it this year since Sunset Overdrive comes out, you know, on Halloween. So duty calls, you know, playing video games and whatnot. But I'm looking forward to doing some videos on them and whatever these I'll do next week. We'll have to see how it all turns out next week. So that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you've been updated. Do not forget to follow me on Facebook and hope you guys have a nice weekend. Sorry that was kind of a lengthy vlog again. You got to put up with these lengthy vlogs. But thank you for understanding and listening, and thank you for watching to the end. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.